Welcome to St. Joseph's this weekend as we celebrate Little Christmas, the feast of the Epiphany of our Lord. My name is Teresa Bologna, and leading us in prayer today is Father Mike. Epiphany means manifestation or showing forth. The God of love is revealed to us in unexpected ways. On this Feast of the Epiphany, we open our hearts and raise our eyes so that we may see the subtle manifestation of God's love in our lives. In this spirit, let us begin our worship now by raising our voices together in praise of God with the hymn, We Three Kings, found in your worship program. But first, let us stand to greet one another in the body of Christ.
Actually, our opening hymn will be number 438 in your blue hymnal, Angels from the Realms of Glory, number 438.
Gather this Feast of the Epiphany, and with the sages from long ago, we follow the star, the light of Christ. Our faith in him has drawn us here together this day, and in our worship we do him homage, and we open our lives to his truth, his way. As we begin our Eucharist, let's bow before the tender love and mercy of God that God has for us revealed through Jesus, our light. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, your glory was revealed through the guidance of a star. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, light of the world, you are forever the Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba, shall come, bearing gold and frankincense and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
The words of our psalm this afternoon are, every nation on earth will adore you, Lord.
chosen. With justice he will govern your people, your afflicted ones with right judgment. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord.
Justice shall flower in his days, lasting peace till the moon be no more. Sea to sea, from the river to the ends of the earth.
Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord. Every nation on earth will adore you, Lord.
And the isles offer gifts. Those from Sabia and Arabia bring tribute. All kings shall pay him homage. All nations shall serve him.
Every nation on earth will adore.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promised in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying,
Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. I received a Christmas card this year from a beloved staff member. She's usually at this Mass, but I don't see her here. It's probably better. The card was a cartoon that gave a depiction of the story in today's gospel. And so there's Mary holding the child Jesus. Saint Joseph is standing next to her. And opposite them, the three magi, the kings, with their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And there's a caption above Mary that says, "What? No diapers?" And below the card on the front, it said, "The last male-sponsored baby shower in history." The humor of the card highlights the unusual elements and gifts in the story that Matthew weaves from this scene in the infancy narrative in his gospel. Obviously, it's more than a baby shower of the usual gifts. It's an intricately told story that teaches something very deep about the child while presenting all of us a challenge to open our eyes, to see with the eyes of faith, to recognize the newborn king as the light of the world, the light to all the nations, light for all humanity. There are so many elements and details in the story that speak to the quest for God, the search for meaning that's in every human heart. I'd like to point to a simple detail in the story, a contrast that the scripture scholar Father Michael Simone, a Jesuit, pointed out in a commentary on the gospel that I think gives us something to ponder and to grapple with. He points to the sharp differences between the two groups in the story, the contrasting groups of people. The first group are those who knew where to find the child, but did not seek him. The second group are those who didn't know where to find him, yet were seeking him with great sacrifice, and even at great personal peril and danger. Now, the first group are the insiders, Jesus' own people, represented by Herod, his court, and the assembled religious leaders and scribes together. It didn't take them long to know where the child was. They consulted the scriptures in Bethlehem of Judea. They knew where to find him, but they didn't go. They didn't seek to know him. Rather, they desired to harm him, reject him, and even kill him. This is a dark shadow that falls across the Christmas story that Matthew tells for a purpose. It predicts Jesus' saving death when the civil authorities and religious authorities, the leaders, got together to collaborate in his crucifixion. It's foreshadowed here in the Christmas story. Now, that second group of people, they're the outsiders, the foreigners from the East who don't know where to find him. Yet they are drawn by the light, by the guidance of a star to seek him. They represent the great surprise that the early members of our faith, those first Christians, encountered when the pagans, the foreign Gentiles, were drawn in great numbers to the new way, who asked for baptism and wanted to be united into the body of Christ. This caused the church in its infancy to recognize a deep truth that they weren't expecting, that in Jesus, God's love has no limits, no boundaries. God's mercy embraces all. As we heard in the second reading that Larry read for us, in God's Spirit, St. Paul says, the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. This changed everything and opened the horizons of those early believers' hearts through the eyes of faith to recognize that that in Christ there are no outsiders, but all are welcome to seek him, the strangers, the desperate, the poor, victims displaced by war and violence. Those who need him are welcome to seek him. And not only these, but also seekers of a different sort, perhaps you and me, who long for meaning in life, a life worth living, a life with purpose and love. So there are two contrasting groups in the story, those who know where to find him and those who don't know but still seek him out. But we know where to find him. Are we seeking him? Are we seeking him in each other? As St. Matthew elsewhere in the gospel tells us, in Jesus' own words, where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst. Jesus is with us here in his body, the church. Also in Matthew's gospel, we are reminded very strongly in chapter 25 where to find him. In the poor, the needy. I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty and you gave me to drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. Father Kishore's ministry in our midst, a man who came to us from the Far East, ministering in our community, is a visible reminder to us that we are Catholic, universal, and that Christ is in everyone. And he's here to remind us of that. We find him also, if we seek him, in his word. He is so present to us, especially in the Gospels. His very words we hear with power to touch our hearts, to change our lives. All we have to do is to listen to him. And as Catholic Christians, we seek him and we find him in the sacraments, in baptism. We're washed clean and made new and are filled with his Spirit. And as Catholics, we turn to the altar, in the sacrament of the altar, and we find in these sacred signs a communion with his life and his way, as bread is broken and given, as the chalice is poured out in love, we see his love present, his way, and we seek to be nourished at this table by Jesus himself, so that we can break open our lives and care for others and pour out our love to those close to us and those far away. Through our worship, we come to Jesus and offer homage and present gifts, not gold, frankincense, and myrrh, not even diapers. But what do we bring? I'd like to end with something that I share almost every Epiphany celebration since I've been with you here at St. Joseph. A few lines from the beautiful poem of Christina Rossetti that's been put to music countless times. The poem, "In Bleak Midwinter." And she sings, "What can I give him, poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I would give a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would do my part. Yet what I can, I give him. Give my heart." Let us profess our faith now in him who is light from light. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Because we receive precious gifts from God above, we don't hesitate to place our trust in God and offer our prayers and petitions.
Let us pray for the universal and local church. Shine upon the members of your church, O Lord, and guide our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all the bishops by your light. Bless those who are seeking you and journeying in the Catholic faith with us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our world. May all the nations walk by your light, O Lord. Enable national leaders to see new horizons for peace and worldwide understanding. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those without promise. Lord Jesus, light of redeeming love, shine on those who despair and are unable to trust. May the transforming grace of the Spirit overcome all obstacles to true faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the sick and the suffering. Show forth your healing power to our friends, Sammy Calhoun, Dominica Vanni, Jerry and Don Malash, Lynette Walters, Ellie Coder, Seal Hosner, Rosemary Chewy, and for all those in need of our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the dead. May our beloved dead rise in splendor to eternal glory, especially Arthur Kuligowski, Joseph Betty, Estelle Rads Kolaski, Raymond Nancy and Carol Ann Osinski, and Ken Reed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Gracious God, open our hearts to appreciate our Eucharistic celebration more deeply. Help us to listen carefully and to trust the work of the Holy Spirit in our lives and the life of our parish. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of creation, Father of love, we give you thanks for your Son, Jesus, who lights the way for us. We present our needs and prayers, our hopes and dreams, everything to you in his name, who lives with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please join our song as the gifts are being presented. On the back page of your Christmas program, We Three Kings of Orient Are. It's also number 463 in the blue hymnal, 463.
Fountain, moor, and mountain, follow
bitter perfume breathes a life of gathering gloom. Sorrowing, sighing, bleeding, dying, sealed in the stone cold tomb. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright.
Brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which now are offered not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Lord, you are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. We celebrate the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, eternal with you in your glory, appeared in a human body, truly sharing our flesh. And so, Father, make holy these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, all the clergy, the religious, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray now to the Father of all, the prayer of Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Please join our communion song found in your Christmas program, The First Noel. It's also number 460 in the blue hymnal, 460.
Was to certain worship.
What Child Is This? In your program, and also 466 in the blue hymnal.
Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's be seated for the announcements.
In your kindness, please remember the family of Arthur Kuligowski in your prayers. Mass of Christian burial was celebrated here for Mr. Kuligowski on Saturday. In Marion Hall, following this Mass, you will find representatives selling St. Joseph's School gala tickets and new tags on the Boughs of Blessing tree requesting gloves and mittens for the needy. Please see the Voice or our website for details on all upcoming events and opportunities, including Revive, Refresh, and Renew, a class on Sacraments of Initiation this Tuesday at 6:15, the Tea Time Book Studies, both daytime and evening sessions, beginning this Thursday, and lastly, the Ministry Appreciation Dinner is just around the corner on Friday, January 20th. All those who volunteer or serve in a ministry here at St. Joseph's Parish and School are invited to this annual fun event. Please RSVP by way of our website or call the parish office. Guests are invited to bring a small dessert to share.
Thank you, Larry. I believe this afternoon at 2:00, there's a senior bingo in Marion Hall with soup and refreshments, so I think that's a wonderful event to warm up a cold winter day. Speaking of a cold winter day, this morning we had our St. Joseph Maverick athletes, the girls and boys basketball teams. They were all assembled here with their coaches, and I gave them a blessing, and I said I probably should have blessed the Lions yesterday. I want to thank our music ministry all through the Christmas season. You've done a wonderful job. Thank you so much. Okay. Let's stand and pray for God's blessings. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. We go now in the light and the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. And our closing song in your Christmas program, Angels We Have Heard on High, also 430 in the blue hymnal, 430.
Angels, we know.